release of FileMaker Server version 19, Claris has just released the first version of a Linux-compatible FileMaker Server software. So today, we're going to be taking a look at how you would set that up and how you interface with that. So the first thing that we need to do is obviously install the server itself. We're going to assume that at this point you've installed at least a Linux OS on a server running CentOS version 7.7. So that's where we're starting. From there, there are two packages that you'll need to run the install. The first you can see here is the wget, which will allow us to get packages from the web using URLs. So we'll need that. And the second is the uninstall package, or the unzip package, which will allow us to unzip the installer once we've downloaded that. So you can see here, we have those two commands that we'll need to run before we get started with anything else. From there, you're going to use the wget command, which can be seen here. And then you would put in your URL of the download link for both the installer and your license certificate. So you'll need to download both of those. Once that's complete, we'll run the next command and we'll be back here in just 1 second. All right, so we're back. We've downloaded everything we need. We can now run this command, as you can see here, to list out our directory and see that we do have the Linux server zip. And we've actually already run the unzip command, but to show you that, you can unzip the package using this command, and that will unzip it here. So once that's done, you're actually ready to install. So let me show you that command really quickly. So there we have the install command. We want to make sure that we actually grab the file name. So you could do just like this. And it's going to ask you to accept the terms. It may ask you a few other things. And then it's going to go ahead and run the installer. So we'll cut to when this is done and finish up the install. All right, we're back. The installer just finished running. And we've run this command. That way we can make sure that the server installed properly. As you can see now, we have listed out all of our FMS commands that we need. You can manage the server via this command line, but it's much easier to use the admin console. So you can still use the admin console for Linux servers, sign in the same way as you normally would. And you can see here, the admin console is actually nearly identical. But you will see that the file paths are obviously going to be slightly different as we are on Linux. So you can manage everything you need directly from the admin console. And if you guys have any questions or need any help setting this up, feel free to contact us.